okay, fine, today let me have some revision again, because the power interruptions and these issues, we have faced the problem. What do you see now? What is the use of, what is the method that we can use to send and execute both select and non-select SQL query operation in database software from JDBC application? So better to use what? Execute method. This execute method returns Boolean, okay? Where we pass a string query and this method throws the SQL exceptions, either you handle or throw, okay? This method returns true when you perform select query based operation. Select query based operations. And this method returns false when it sends and executes non-select query. Okay, boss? Fine. So to use, instead of using this one, you can use get result set on statement object to gather result set when execute, when execute methods send and executes select SQL query in database software. So apart from this one, select SQL query, we can go for to find out the count, how many records are affected for insertion, for updation, and for deletion. In that case, you can use get update count. Get update count on which objects? On statement object to gather the value that represents number of records that affected when execute method send and execute non-select query. Means first use execute query, it will bring some true or false. If false means this will bring what, boss? Non-select query. If true means this will execute the select query. And if it is select query means true. Check by using if else condition. If it is true, then go for get result count and get the number of results. Okay, fine, boss. What are the points? What about the jar or environment variable? This is about environment variable that we have gone, but because of power cut, we forget to take the recordings for this. Points to be remembered while working with the my computer environment variable. So user variable are specific to the currently logged in computer user or Windows user, whereas system variables are visible to all the Windows users, those who are logged in, whereas system users are visible to all those who will log in. But in that case, maybe the admin, maybe the guest, or maybe any authenticated users. What are the values you are placing in a system variable or user environment variable that must be separated by commas? Otherwise, what will happen? That path cannot be found from the runtime environment, from the terminal. So in that case, if you have to separate two different variables, what do you have to use? Semicolon, and at last to place as a dot symbol, guys. Same apply for class path and path. So take an example. I opened my terminal. And after opening this terminal, I gone to environment variable. So after entering into an environment variable, so here I modified some path, class path or path. After I modified this path and class path, this won't affect to the existing already opened terminal. So in that case, you have to close the terminal, modify the all the newly added environment variables from the path or class path, then you can work with the terminal again. So this is the point. Only we tried this one last time. And you can go for path or class path, whatever you will feel comfort, guys. Next, we proceed for user-defined API development. How to proceed for user-defined API development? So, what are the APIs? As in the case of Java, the APIs are a programming interface. It's an interface between the language vendor, Java language vendor, JDK software, and programmer. By using this interface, programmer can able to write suitable or requirement specific application as per the customer's needs. So they have to use these predefined APIs with the help of JARs. These JARs may be JDK supplied JARs, these JARs may be programmer created JARs, or maybe third party given JARs, guys. And the JAR is nothing but it's an archive, it's an compressed file, which is in the form of .jar. Okay. And Java environment contains, what are the jars, guys? This is a compressor, it can reduce the drivers, we can use jars for web applications or EGP components. And it is totally directly installable software. Okay? You need not go for next finish. Just use the jar, place in a class path and path environment variable, directly that file will be available for your runtime environment. Next, we'll proceed for this creation of understanding of the jar file and creation of jar file. Okay, boss, fine. So what is jar? Jar is a built-in tool which is available where boss in computer C, where I install program files. Here is my Java, here is my JDK, and here is my bin. Just check it here, where jar is there. Yeah, here is the jar tool, boss. Here is the jar tool, guys. Let me proceed for creation of the jar. Let me create a folder called apps test, and I'm having e drive contains apps folder, apps contains test folder, test contains a.txt and b.txt, guys. Let me go to e drive. Where is my e drive? Here is my e drive. Okay, install this one. Let me go to e drive. Create one new folder, guys. Okay, this is my which folder, boss? Apps. In this apps, I'm creating which one? Test. Okay. And in this test, I want to create what, boss? A dot txt and b dot txt. How to create? Let me create copy con. A dot txt. Let me write some text, guys. What are the text? You can write any text. What is the text you want? This is something about the programming. This is something about the programming. Okay, boss. Fine. One file is copied. Let me create now again b.txt. Okay, fine. Just write something fastly. Something was not a great. Take example is Java code. A dummy. Okay. I'll write something, boss. Control Z, enter. Two files are ready in my test, a.txt and b.txt. b.txt. Okay, boss, fine. What I want to do, I want to place these two things in where, boss? In jar. In jar. So here is my jar tool. What is the command? Jar cf. Jar cf, next to file name, archive dot jar space, where I want to create in my current directory. Just see here, archive dot jar, it's a jar file. Right click, properties, it's a jar file. Got it, na? So this is the way to create the jar. Okay, boss, fine. Let me go to terminal. Let me mark. Copy. Enter. Paste. Is my folder in there? Paste. Okay? Fine. Here the jar is created, guys. Now you can take this command. Which command, boss? Here. There is a man. Underline this one. Right here. Jar is a tool. It's a tool. Java tool. Okay? Here C. Underline C. And then write. Write C. Create archive file. C belongs to create archive file. F underline kara and F chali arwak diya. User specified file name. user specified file name as archive. As archive file name. Okay, boss. And dot represents current directory. Okay, boss, fine. Let me delete all the txt files from the command. Del star dot txt. Any txts are there? Okay, boss, removed now. Okay, fine. Now, what I want to do, boss, suppose you want to add one more file. Copy con. I want to add .c.txt, guys. C.txt. I want to add this file into existing jar file that is archive dot jar. Okay, I want to add this content to c.txt, and this file should be added to where, boss? Okay, file into archive dot jar. Control Z, enter, boss. Now I'm having one more file ready, boss.
So this file is ready along with me. What I want to do? Mouse.
थोडीशी उघडी ठेव फक्त खिडकी, जास्त नको ओपन करू. माझ्या असं हवा येईल, छानपैकी हवा येईल. थोडीशी उघडी ठेव फक्त. चल वरती चढ. चढ रे तू, चढ वरती चढ. हा बंद करते. अरे चढ म्हणाल वरती तुला मी. हा उचलून घे, उचलून आता. हा अस बस सोड, बस झालं, सोड, चल. जेवण करावं तसं चांगलं. हा ओके बॉस, फाईन. पाऊस चांगला होतोय, मला बघण्याची इच्छा आहे, पण ते काय करणार. सोडा गाईज, व्हॉट आय वॉन्ट टू ॲड दिस न्यू फाईल. विच फाईल बॉस? सी डॉट टी एक्स टी. इंटू वेअर बॉस? इंटू एक्झिस्टिंग जार. So to add this file, what do you have to do?
Basically, let me get into
system.
Yeah. No, but we decide again.
Okay, boss. I want to add this c.txt. Where is my c.txt, boss? In my test folder. Here is the test folder. Have you seen this file? I want to add into where, boss? Into jar. Into which jar? Into this archive.jar, guys. Fine. So write the command here again. How to add new file? So you can use. Now, C for create. Now, this time I want to update. You can use tf command. Which file? TF command. archive.jar. Okay. Sorry. Not TF. We're gonna go for VF. It is showing that invalid version, invalid option. Let me check if it is added or not. Last time I tried, but. We can open the jar file by using what boss? Here. Okay, still not added. Let me add. Okay, boss, fine. So, are Amma, it's not working. This mouse is not working. I think I had to reboot my system. Okay, leave it. Connect again. To add new file to my existing jar, okay. To add, let me try with tf command. Let me add with the tf command. Okay, boss, fine. Where is the tf command? There is a tmat tf command. Let me test. Open. Not added, boss. Updates are U. Where is the U? Update existing archives. Fine, boss. Let me verify once again. Can you see here? Okay. A dot B dot C. You can open it. You can see this is the newly added jar. Okay. Fine, boss. So to add, you can work with the UEF command. Which command, boss? UEF. It was right. UEF. How to add, guys? Look at here. I haven't given the file name. You can give the file name also. C dot txt. Okay. C dot txt. Where is that? Open that this jar. Okay, boss, fine. Let me test once again. Fine, boss. Alright. Understood? Fine. If I want to I want to view the contents of the jar file. Okay? We can use tf command. We can use what, boss? Tf. Tf is not working. Let me see. Look at here. If I use the tf, what are the contents are available? That you can see here. Now, apart from this one, I want to extract the jar, guys. I want to extract the jar. We can use xf. What you can use? XF. Now you can see here. All are extracted. Meta NF, A, B, C, and char. Extracted. You can extract anything, boss. Anything. Any jar. So write this command if you want to write. If you want to add any new things. We can go from adding here. Fine, boss. Here is for creating jar. Creating jar. Here is for updating jar. Updating. Jar. Okay, before this let me create the c dot txt. So here is my copy gone. What are the content I written over there? C dot txt. So I want to copy this file. I want to copy this file and copy or place this file into existing archive.jar file. Okay boss, here file is created now. One file is copied now. Here what you'll get boss, one file is copied. I'm going to control B. One file is copied now. So this is for updating. This is for extracting the contents of the .jar file. This will show you only. Let me remove these options. Sorry, not extracting. For listing. This is for single listing only. This is for what? Extracting the jar files into currently working directory or folder. And what is here boss? What is here? Looking the contents. Looking for the contents. Okay boss, fine. This is about the jar. Understood? Are you clear now guys? Okay, fine. Take one note point for this. By default, every jar file, every jar file contains, what it contains boss? Manifest file that is manifest.mf. In which folder? meta-inf. Okay boss, what I want to do, guys, we'll create our own class, okay? That we'll place in a class path, okay? Creating and running my own programmer defined jar file. creating and running my own programmer defined jar file. Fine guys, what I'm trying to do guys, apart from this one, I want to get one application guys for this first. Okay, let me create one application. Wherever you want to create, you can create guys, not a great deal. Altf. Let me create one Java file. This is my main app. Okay, this main app is a public class. Public class main app. It contains what boss? Let me create one more class. Let me create one more class. Public class demo. Okay, boss, fine. It contains one method. Public void say hello. Say hello. Okay, boss, fine. It does not contain anything. It cannot get all logic. System.out.println. Okay, fine, boss. This is from demo.say hello. Okay, boss. Fine. Let me call this demo from here. Demo D is equal to new demo of. Okay. Fine. D dot say hello. Okay, boss. And let me print here. Today's date is. Yeah, let me pass here. What was? New java dot util dot date of. Okay, boss, let me save. Where I have to save? Wherever you want to save. Okay, this is my main app. Okay, main app only, nah? Okay, boss, fine. Now what I want to do, I want to place this Java class in jar file, guys. Where? Main class in a Java file. Fine. CMD. Java C. How to create Java? First, let me compile, na? Java C. Okay, what are the jar? Dot. Java. Why use a star? Why the star, boss? Why I use the star over there, guys? Because I want to compile the class. What are the classes available into that folder? I want to compile all. Are you getting? Now you will find two dot class files, guys. What you will find? Two dot class files, main and demo. Okay. Fine, boss. Let me create the jar file of this one. How to create the jar, guys? Tell me. How to create jar space cf space what I want to create here? Create what is my jar name? My API dot jar. I want to create in current directory. Okay, boss. My jar is ready now. Here is my right click properties. You can see here jar. Can you observe here? This is a jar file, guys. I tried to open by using WinRAR because that reason it is asking for me for WinRAR. Okay, my jar is ready. When you open this jar, you will find unnecessary stuff, guys. What are those? Main app.java. Let me delete, this is not required to me. This is not required to me. And here manifest, guys. Here is the manifest. What I want to do, I want to place this jar. Look at here. I'm going terminal now. Where am I now? On home. C drive, na? I want to run my Java. Main app. What you will get, boss? Main app cannot find, na? Because this is available somewhere. In E drive, I'm searching from here. So I want to place this main app. Where? I want to place this main app In where, boss? In my where, boss? Environment variable. Because it should run wherever I want to run. Play this file. Environment variable. Go to class path. I have to paste at last. Semicolon. Click on OK. Okay, boss. Fine. Let me close all these terminals. Let me go to here where boss. This is my command prompt. Okay. Now let me run here. Java main app. What you are getting now? Demo say hello. Today's date is? Whatever the date is. Are you getting what I mean to say? If I go to D drive, run the application, boss. If I go to E drive, run the application. You go to anywhere, boss, wherever you want to go. I want to run from here. Wherever you want to go. Are you getting what I mean to say? Wherever I want to compile from my apps. Sorry, what is my application name? Main app. Can I able to run or not? It is this main app is available here, boss. In where, boss? In J drive. One Java, then Java, and 14F folder. Are you getting? But I could be able to run from anywhere, na? So this is my API. Understood how to create the jar, guys? And how to create our own application? Are you clear now? Understood? Okay, boss, fine. Now today we have learned how to create the jar, how to run the application. Understood? So here, Control A, Control C. You can create anything, boss. Okay? Compile the above application. Above main app.java. Okay? And create the jar. What is the jar, boss? What is the command? Jar space. CF space any file name. My jar na. What is the name I give? My APIs na? My API dot jar. Or programmer API dot jar space dot. Then enter. You will get what, boss? My API. My API dot jar. Okay. Then what I'm trying to do. Where is my jar? My jar is here, boss. What I have to do? My api.jar I want to take. Place this file in a class path. Place. Keep this path. Path of the my API. My API dot. My API dot. Jar. In where, boss? Class path. Okay, separated by keep this path of the my api.jar in the class path separated by what, boss? Semicolon symbol. And you can be able to run the what, boss? Main app file or main app java application. What, mama? I am in class madhe ahe nantar phone karto, please. Gari nahi pochlo amki. Nahi pochlo amki, me gari pochal, theek hai? क्लास मध्ये आहे माझा क्लास 6 ला सुटणार आहे साढ़े साल फोन करते ओके एंड यू कैन एबल टू रन द मेन ऐप डॉट जावा एप्लीकेशन फ्रॉम एनीवेयर फ्रॉम योर कंप्यूटर ओके एंजॉय ओके बॉस फाइन जस्ट वी हैव सीन दिस वन व्हाट आई डन आई गॉन टू पाथ एंड क्लास पाथ प्रॉपर्टीज एनवायरमेंट वेरिएबल हियर इज माय एनवायरमेंट वेरिएबल एंड हियर आई सेट माय J:1 java/java/14 /myapi.jar I set here and I can able to run from anywhere boss either in E drive either in J drive or in D drive or in C drive okay boss fine this is about what boss jar understood let's proceed for Let's proceed for. I think I gave to you what is the difference between class path and path. Did I give?
Yes, sir.
Okay, boss. Fine. Let me ask one question. Interview question, guys. In group also I will ask, but here also I would have to ask one more question, and let me give the answer for this question. Interview me ask the question like what are the three class loader class loader regularly used in Java environment Okay, boss. Fine. So, first is bootstrap class loader. This uses the context of rt.jar is rt.jar is available where boss look at here computer c drive program files java jdk jre lib and you can find here rt can you find here it's an jar file guys it's an jar file can you see here okay boss fine next class path class loader so here uses the context of directories. Uses the context of directories, comma, jar files added to class path. Okay, boss. Fine. Next, extension. Class loader here uses the content of jar files added to ext folder which is available in where boss same again I let me move to here c drive program files Java JDK.
JDK.
Next step we go to GRE.
Next step we go to here, lib.
And here find what? EXT. This EXT contains, this is the context of your
extension class loader.
Okay? Okay boss, fine. There are three different class loaders. Okay boss, to just in the previous classes that I asked you, that I'll say to you, I'll prove you how to create the user defined APIs and how to run those APIs. Today my intention is to prove that one.
Next, let me proceed for
okay. Let me give the example of this one. Let me give some explanation about this one. Okay.
Here.
When
when we develop
Java application
having
multiple classes,
then
we generally pack them into jar file
to deliver the application
to the client and we execute the application and we execute
the application
in the form of jar file.
Okay boss, fine. So
One thing I forget to tell you guys, let me check that is available or not. Here is manifest. Select the program from the list. I want to use Redplus. Okay boss, I'm not able to see here. Actually here it should contain mainapp.java. Okay. It should contain what boss?
Mainapp.java.
That's it. So this I was expecting, but it's not here. But please just hold on. Let me close. Are you all? Okay, boss, fine. Where were each?
Next.
In this situation, we must
prepare
a manifest file.
Which file was?
Manifest file. File name. By specifying by specifying the class name in which public static void main method exist is available or exist. Okay boss, fine. When this jar file is given for execution the class in which public static void main method is placed, main method is placed becomes ready for execution. Okay boss, fine. Guys, this was a scene now. What I want to do, I want to run my jar directly only. So to run this jar directly, let me paste here. Okay, let me open this one, let me open this close, and let us search for here is my main, this is my manifest, and here let me write one more. Okay boss, fine. Install this install predefined created class jar. Let me create my one more jar. Let me use this demo class again. Control C, okay, Control V, Control X. Let me create one more folder, guys. Okay, my jar, Control V. Let me go to terminal, cmd. cmd. Okay boss, what I want to do, here is my main app.java. okay, main app.java. now just now we have seen, but how can you run this java? How can I run this Java? Now what I want to do, I want to create my own manifest. Just create the main own manifest and then execute. Are you getting what I mean to say? So my jar should be auto-executable now. But without placing in a class path. Okay boss, here let me proceed for remaining things. What I want to do next, I want to create here E, where I stored, here is my application boss, my jar. Okay, here I want to create my one application. Not E, J colon. This file contains one more same logics, but I want to go in different way. Control A, Control C, or main app. Let me keep it as main app only. Leave it. Okay, main app 1, 2, 3. Fine. Main app 1, 2, 3. Now let me compile my jar, guys. Let me compile my Java class. java c star dot java. Compile successfully. Now what I want to do, let me remove this one, shift delete, I removed. I want to create one manifest file by my own, altf new normal text. What I want to write here, control s, I want to store into where boss, my jar, in my jar, here I want to store. Let me give the name here, my manifest. Hold on, what is the name by default here? Manifest.mf, na? Let me give the same name as here, or not required also. My manifest.mf. Okay, boss, fine. Save here. You can see the extension. Okay, fine, guys. manifest -- version, okay, colon, here is the space, guys, here is the space, just you have to same as copy, guys, that's not a great deal. What are the things which is available from here, where already created jars, which one, this floating dot jar, look at here, manifest. Are you getting? What I mean to say, are you getting, boss? Just copy this one also. And you can place here. Control A, Control V. Just what I'm going to remove here. I want to create my own class name. What is my main class name? Main app, na? Main app 1, 2, 3. Okay. Dot Java. Also, what I want to do, boss, this file also contains other two classes, na? Now just where I compile, what are those? Main app dot class, na? 1, 2, 3 dot class. One more class, boss, which one? Demo or test? Demo dot class. I am going to create one more file, guys. What is that file? My manifest dot mf. Okay, okay, boss, fine. Here is my manifest. What I want to write here, one property, guys. What is the property? What is the main class, guys? Fine. Okay, what is the main class name? Main app 1, 2, 3. Okay. Okay, boss, fine. Let me save. I saved. Now let me get what, boss? Let me get jar now. Let me create the jar. Jar space. What is the file name? CMF with manifest file, na? Okay. What is the file name? My manifest.mf. What is the application name? What is the jar name? My jar. My API. API. Dot jar. My API jar. Or I forget to give the dot. Okay, boss. Just check it here. Where is your my jar? You can see here, boss. It contains my manifest. Okay, meta inf. Fine, boss. Okay, boss, let me try to run this application. How can I run? To run this one, you have to use java-jar space. What is your jar name? My API dot jar. Then can I call my jars are auto executable files? Did I prove or not? Okay, boss, fine. You can note down these steps. Fine. Here, creating creating your own application. Creating your own application, own Java application in the form of auto executable jar file. Okay, boss, fine. So the code is, I haven't done anything great. Just I took this this main app dot jar, okay? And I think I removed that code, boss. Okay, well, and decompiler, we'll enjoy with the decompiler, boss. Okay? Copy this code, Control C, okay, and paste into here, boss. Is it dot class have a file code, na? Huh? And here what, boss? What I need here? It is asking for new. Look at here, what internal is doing. What I wrote here? Only today's date I wrote something, okay? New, it is internally calling string builder. And appending today's date is, it is again appending new date and converting that new date to two string. This code is not generated by me, boss. This code is generated by whom? Java compiler. Got it, boss? Okay, fine. This is my code. In where? In my main app dot java, and then we create one more demo class, na? So let me open that demo also. Where is my demo? Here is my demo. So here is my demo class. Okay, boss, fine. And what is my manifest file name? What is the manifest file name, boss? My manifest. My manifest.mf. Control C. Control V. Okay, boss, fine. Let me copy that lines. I think I removed. Let me open my manifest file. Control C, here is Control V. Okay, boss, now next what should I do? Next, let me write the command from the console. Now I can place this file anywhere and I can run anywhere, na? Okay, I did not type Java space. Otherwise, let me show you one more example, guys. Okay, let me show you one more example that directly how to run. Okay, enter Control V. Okay, boss, what I will do, RTF, new, normal text, java space hyphen jar space, what is my file name, boss? Jar file name? Okay, let me copy this one, Control A, Control V. Control S, my batch dot bat. Okay, boss, fine. Let me store into here. Okay, save. This is one more way, guys. One more style. Now, I won't go to terminal also. Here is na my batch file. Just enter. Blinking and going, na. Are you getting what I mean to say? Just here, pause.
Fine.
Okay. Is it clear to you, boss? Okay, guys. It's my duty to whatever things that I say to you to prove you. I done as my level best. Okay, boss. Fine. Fine, boss. This is the these are the ways where. Fine, boss. All standalone application. Shut up. All standalone Java projects. All standalone Java projects. All standalone Java projects will be released. Will be released to the client. To the clients in the form of .jar file without knowing the content of the jar file. Okay, boss. Fine. Third party supplied vendors or third party vendors and database vendors releases their JDBC drivers in the form of jar files. For example, Oracle Corporation gives the JDBC drivers in the form of OJDBC 14.jar file. If you open your Oracle installation bin folder, you'll find there what was, what you can find, the jar files of the OJDBC 14.jar, which is having the connectivity between what your Java application to the Oracle database by using type 4 driver. Are you getting boss? Fine. Now okay, we'll proceed for now various types of drivers. Okay, type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4, and type 5 we'll see at last. Okay,
are kale kon tumi
haldi aga hoyta tumi kharas. Okay, boss, your wish.